Governor Sununu, thanks for taking some time with us. First, just share with us some of your thoughts upon the passing of the 41st President, George H.W. Bush.
Well, you know, no matter how much you anticipate it's imminent, when it does happen, it really does hit you. And the country's lost a great president, and I've lost a great friend.
Explain what, in your view, he has meant to this country. Certainly, you've written a book about it, but this is someone who served almost his entire life.
Well, he cared about the country. He understood it. He knew he came from privilege, and yet that didn't stop him. He wanted to give back. He had a great history of service, but as president in particular, I think he had a huge impact on the world. He guided us through a transition that was amazingly smooth, almost made it look too easy. I don't think people still appreciate how complicated it was dealing with personalities like Mikhail Gorbachev and then Margaret Thatcher and Francois Mitterrand, who really didn't want the unification of Germany at first. And George Herbert Walker Bush managed that whole process. But he also had a huge impact domestically. His budget agreement produced the first surpluses, even though they happened at the end of the five-year period of the budget agreement in the Clinton administration. They were George Bush surpluses, and he passed the most significant environmental legislation, the amendments to the Clean Air Act that had been tied up for 13 years, the Americans with Disabilities Act, which certainly has had a huge impact on an important segment of our population, the Civil Rights Bill. He opened up the process to making America energy independent with the Energy Policy Act that he passed and the rules and regulations that he put on the table. His impact domestically was huge. It's gone unappreciated, but I think people are going to go back and appreciate the fact that in one term he passed more domestic legislation than any president except Lyndon Johnson or Franklin Roosevelt.
How would you describe his leadership style?
He really had a great knack for recognizing that there were two sides to difficult situations, and he worked very hard to put himself in the other person's shoes. He did that with Mikhail Gorbachev, understanding the pressures Gorbachev had from the hardliners. He did that with Danny Rostenkowski, and chairman of the budget process in the democratically controlled House when we were doing the budget. He worked hard to make everything a win-win success.
Obviously, anyone who comes to New Hampshire is tested, and this was already a fairly tested individual through World War II and many different situations, but New Hampshire's different. How did this state shape the president who would become?
Well, you know, he really didn't like the politics of politics, but he recognized he better understand how to do it. And what better place to learn politics than running for president in New Hampshire? It's see me, touch me, feel me. And he adapted to it pretty quickly. I remember when he came out of Iowa with that not good result in Iowa in 88, and he had to win in New Hampshire. We worked him awfully hard. We had him going to breakfast at McDonald's and Denny's and Dunkin' Donuts and making him, and I think the right word is making him, because it was political and he wasn't comfortable to begin with, making him interact with people, and pretty soon he got used to the see me, touch me, feel me requirements of politics in New Hampshire, and I think it stood him in good stead as he continued that primary process across the country.
And certainly it altered the trajectory of your life as well. I mean, you're already the governor of New Hampshire, but what was it like to just be a part of that White House?
Well, if I had to stress one aspect of it, I would stress the fact that it was fun. We really had fun in that White House, working on important things, on difficult things. The president encouraged folks to give different viewpoints, a lot of arguing going on, but when he came to a decision, we worked hard to support exactly what the president wanted. Mrs. Bush wrote about it in her book. She talked about walking past that our morning meeting, which took place from 8 to about 9:30 every day. As she walked Millie, she said all she heard was raucous laughter. from behind those closed doors and couldn't understand how those people could run the world that way.
So, and this is a very big picture, big question, but if you had to just describe the legacy that George H.W. Bush leaves behind, what would that be?
Well, I think he showed America that you can have a warm personality, you can be smart, and you can be nice, and you can get good things done.
All right. Governor Sununu, thank you so much for your time.